All right, the recording is on. I just started with the recording. So the get rich quick scheme adventure will always die poor. First thing, in this market, for you to be very successful, you have to remove it's very important that you have to remove the mind from get rich quick adventures. Right now, what I'll just do is I'll just go through how I do my thing, and then I talk about the psychology part later. I'll just delete this one. I will explain how I do my trade. It's very simple. Basically, all I do is just price action. All what you need to understand these levels you see on my chart. All these levels you see on my chart that is color coded in the blue, red, blue, red, blue, red. You just need to understand them. So that's what I'll still be going over that today. So you get to understand that better. Or what I do, once the psychological level is broken, this I call psychological level. And this blue is main psychological level, while the red one is sub-psychological level. Okay. This is a main. This is a main psychological level, this blue. All right. Wow. The red is sub-psychological level. I'll just explain that in a bit. Okay, this is sub-psychological level. The others are just repetition. The others are repetition of this. If you can see this main psychological level, this chart, we're currently on Euro USD H4. On this main psychological level, you can see the price is 1.160000. So now, what are psychological levels? Psychological levels are whole numbers. Okay, they are round up numbers, reasonable numbers, which the banks, the hedges, other guys, they pay close attention to them, because when price gets their price, what tends to what react? People tend to sell at those points and they tend to buy at those points. Demand and supply level meets at those points. So that's why supply and this psychological level are highly relevant. Like the one we have here, let me show you just something that you might not be paying attention to. Can you see at this point, when price got to this point, what happened? There was a reaction. And that point is what is the main psychological level, which is 1.1600. When price also got, it broke through this point, got to what happened? There was a reversal to the upside. And that was 1.14500. Upon that, it went up to test this point. Upon testing this point, 1.15500, what it came back. So just note all these points. Upon testing this point, it reversed. Upon testing this point, what it reversed. Upon testing this point, reversal, reversal, and a reversal at this point soon. So very crucial. Very crucial. These are points that you should note. Okay, now, so another question that might be running through your mind, how do you get the psychological levels on your charts? Okay, let me show you how I do that with a plain chart very easily, very simple. Okay, all you need to know is to know your roundup numbers, is to know your roundup numbers on the chart. Let me pull up an empty chart of Euro USD and I will replicate the same. We'll do that for Euro USD. We'll do that for USD CAD and USD JPY. Okay, on Euro USD right now, we're on 1 hour time frame. So I'll just apply. Because I don't want any indicator on the charts. I think they are just for confirmations. Right now, we have a plain chart. Okay, everyone should have this. You should be writing currently. You should be writing right now. I already told you what psychological levels are and why. Okay, I've not told you why they work. Why they work is, let's say you go out to a place where you want to buy something. You go to a market. We all know here in Nigeria, you can go to market. Most of the things are negotiable. Okay? When you get to places where things are negotiable, when you are being told the price, the first thing is, for you to price to a nearest whole number. For example, let's say you want to buy some apples, and apples are priced at, let's say, 60 naira or 70 naira. The first negotiable price you are going to go to will be what? 50 naira. Okay? Or there are some other people that want to take it to 45 naira. Okay? So These are psychological levels. How this thing also plays in the Forex market. That's the reason why the world, because once price gets to a certain level, so a whole number, people want to price it. People want to buy at that current price. They want to buy, they want to sell at those current prices because they believe it's a better price for them to sell, or it's a better price for them to buy at that current price. So that's just the psychology behind the market. I hope you all get the logic. So that same thing also happened in the Forex market. So putting off the psychological level on your chart, you have to click on this, your horizontal tool. Just anyhow, it's your horizontal tool on your chart. Place it close to the current market price. I want to take it close to the current market price because I don't want a whole lot on my chart. I just want the one that will be relevant to the current market as at that time. So I'll take it close to the current market chart. So currently, the price here, just look at your right-hand side. Okay, look at the right-hand side. Those who are viewing from phone, you might not be able to see it clearly, but maybe you try to flip your phone and zoom in. Look at the price, this point where I'm pointing at. Currently, where I put this, my horizontal line is 1.13062. So what I'll do is I'll just right click and I'll change it to a nearest whole number. I'll change it to a nearest psychological level, which will be 1.130000. That is the next psychological level. You can see how the horizontal tool moved there automatically after I typed it on the line property, the parameters. So I'll change this color. Okay, let's make the red. The red will be what main psychological level. Let me write that out. Red. Red is main psychological level. Why the blue? Why the blue will be sub psychological level? Alright, so first we are gonna fix the main psychological level so we don't get it mixed. Okay, so now here's where I want you guys to be active. Now we want to take it from the bottom up. Now we already have 1.13000. So the next one we have to have will be what? If you know the answer, just drop the answer on the chat box, because if you can crack this, if you already understand the psychology behind the psychological level, you know how to get them on chat, the job is half done. The remaining one I just need to teach you is how to react when they occur. So what would it be? Someone is perfect. Israel is saying 1.12. Perfect, perfect. That's the answer, 1.12. So, sorry, 1.12 rather. 1.12. You just go to horizontal line properties. At this point, you put in 12. You can add 00. Automatically, it's going to do that for you. That line got missing. Yes. All right. Sorry, but I did 1.12. I said going up. It's supposed to be 1.14 rather, not 1.14. Going up will be 1.14. 1.14. Okay. I'll take it back to one hour chart. 1.14. Then the next one will be 1.15. I hope we understand. So this is how to check if you're correct or not. I'll just show you a simple trick on how to check. Because the distance from one main psychological level to another is 100 pips. 100 pips. Then you select your crosshair, you calculate from 1.13 to 1.14. It should be 100 pips difference. Okay? 100 pips difference. Right now, I cannot answer much question. When I'm done, I'll reply this. Okay. So you can see we have three main psychological levels already on the chart. This is 1.13, 1.14, and 1.15. Do you understand how we arrive at this level? If you understand, drop number one on the chart box. No, it doesn't matter the time frame you do it. Let's say we just did it on 1 hour. We can go on 15 minutes. We are going to meet them there. Can you see that? If you go on 5 minutes, you're going to meet them there. They are the same anywhere, irrespective of the time frame you go to. They are the same everywhere. If you understand this concept, drop number one on the chat. Okay. Okay. We all seem to understand this whole thing. Okay. Perfect. So the next thing we are going to get is what our sub-psychological levels. Then we'll go back on a higher time frame so that we have them squeezed. Okay, that's the reason why I'm just going to the higher time frame. Nothing. There's nothing special. That's why I have them squeezed. I can see them easily. So the sub-psychological level is 50 pips difference. Will be 50 pips difference. So sub-psychological level is half of what we already have. It's half of what we already have. Okay, so sub-psychological level, remember we said it's going to be blue. I'm going to put it in between this one we already have. Change it. Then it's now be 1.145. That's half of it, 1.500. Then we'll change the color to blue. Okay, then we're going to have another one again between this one. That will be 1.135. Perfect. I hope you understand the sub-psychological level. If you understand the sub-psychological level, drop number two on the chat box. If this is clear, drop number two on the chat box. I hope you are getting it. If you are not getting it, just specify. I will explain again. If you are not getting it, how we're getting, okay, perfect. All right. So this is what we call psychological level. Whenever you hear me talking about psychological level from the signal channel or from the general group chat or anybody talking about psychological levels, these are what they mean by psychological level. You do not really need a special indicator to draw them for you. Though I have an indicator that draws this automatically on all pairs or any pair of your charts. This work on cryptos, index, futures, anything that is the market. I told you the psychology behind it. So it works on all market and all pairs. So now this is said and done, let's check on USDJPY. Since USDJPY, the PIP calculation is different. Let's USDJPY. Boom. So you just make sure you clear your chart. Okay, we'll repeat the same process. We'll pick our horizontal line. First, we have to look for the main psychological level. So we'll change the color to what, red. So the calculation still remains the same. At this point, it will be what, 1.14.00. That would be the first to be the first main psychological level on JPY, USDJPY, 0.00. So that's 114.00. And the next one will be what? Coming down will be 113. It's as simple as that, very easy to spot. 113. So to cross check if whether you're right or not, just to pull up your crosshair. Calculate from this point to this other point. If it's up to 100 pips, you are right. If it's not up to, you have to cross-check your work. All right? Then the next one will be 112. Boom. We have it right there at the bottom. Okay. We are good. The next thing, we want to have the sub-psychological level. Remember, is 50 pips between them. It's now be 113.5. Then we're changing the color to blue. We repeat the same process here. It will now be 112.5. Very simple. Isn't that simple? Yes, it's very simple. Very simple. You can just repeat the same process everywhere in all pairs. These are psychological levels. And as to how it reacts, let me show you how it works. Guys, can you see this reaction here when it got to this point? What happened? It reversed out to the downside. Yeah? It reversed to the downside. From this point, boom, to the downside. Okay? That's one. When price got to this point, what happened? Can you see the reaction? Can you see the reaction? Come back, test this on and on, and you discover that this is a golden nugget. Let me collect this previous one. Can see this point? Can see the reaction here? Send a reaction. Can see this point? See how this piece is held perfectly. Because when prices get to these levels, buyers, the big guys, the big players, the market makers, they feel it very important for them to buy. Because they know that that level will likely hold. And you shouldn't be viewing this thing. I use them as support and resistance all the time. So since the big guys, they pay attention to this, I don't even bother myself trying to draw my own support and resistance again. This is what I also pay attention to. This is what I pay attention to in the market. Okay? So, and I use this coupled with trend line break and using my TDI for confirmation. That's how I send my trades every day. Okay? That's how I send the trades every day. Now, going back to Euro USD, I want to explain. You guys already know I only trade two pairs. I only trade two pairs, which is Euro USD and GBP USD. I only use my dollar index to determine the strength of the dollar because two of them, they are dollar related. Okay? So what I do, I come on. Now, let's see how it works on the Euro USD. You can see the reaction right here. When price got to this point, can see when price got to this point, what happened? It flushed to the downside. When price got to this point, what happened? Flush to the downside. No secret. When price got to this point, what happened? Flush to the downside. Okay. When price got to the, it broke, got to this point, what happened? It moved right up. When it got to this point, what happened? It gathered another momentum. It came down. This point, it held, came back to this point. And now let me show you a simple strategy how I trade with this. When price gets to the psychological level or the main psychological level, sub-psychological level, main psychological level, what you do is a break, retest of the psychological level, and you trade. Break, retest, trade. That's all I do every day. Break, retest, trade. Break, no retest, no trade. Another strategy is when it gets to psychological level, I see a candle formation, a JCP, Japanese candlestick pattern, right? They're forming a reversal, I sell. Like the one we have here, came to this point, I see that it was unable to break it. It's forming a reversal. Upon this candle, I short. The minimum you can get with this strategy every day is 50 pips. 50 pips, guys. Just only 50 pips. Then if you are so patient, you can hold your trade. You can get 100 pips and even more. Like today on Euro USD, we bagged almost close to 100 pips. Okay, just from the trade idea I gave. Using the same strategy. Using the same strategy. Let me prove that. On 15 minutes, I caught this trade using the counter trend line. I drew my trend line from this point. Upon the break, we entered in. And right now, you can see the results. Boom, to the downside. This is 85 pips. Okay, so guys, when I mean close to 100 pips, it's not mistaken. Minimum you can get every day trading this strategy, break, retest, trade, break, retest, trade, break, retest, no trade. Is 50 pips. Guys, do you understand that? And again, you have to understand something. You don't have to be rushing trades all the time. Once the trade is not doing what you're anticipating or what you're expecting to do, it's best to sit on your hand. Okay? It's best to sit on the hand. Do not expect to have trade all the time. Like for me, I do not expect trades all the time. Now, here's another golden nugget I want to drop before I leave the room open for questions and answer. Okay, you add counter trend line to this. Once you add counter trend line to this, it's the bomb. Now let me show you another example of the counter trend line. This thing happened every day right before our eyes. Here's an example of a counter trend line. Boom, right there. Upon the break, what? You trade to the downside. Here's another one. Upon the break, what happened? It breaks to the downside. With this strategy, I tell you, I guarantee you 50-50 pip movement. Remember, from this blue main psychological level to sub-psychological level, the distance is what? How many pips? From this point, the distance is how many pips? It's what? 50 pips. 50 pips. But from a main psychological level to a main psychological level, the distance is what? 100 pips. Okay? If you understand that, just drop number 2 on the chat box. If you understand what I just said, drop number 2 on the chat box. Okay, someone is saying I should please repeat. Okay, thank you, Vera. Thank you. Someone is saying I should repeat that. Let me just repeat. From main psychological level to a main psychological level, this red one is a main psychological level to a main psychological level, another red one, the distance is what, 100 pips? This is the another easy way to calculate pips without pulling up your crosshair. And from this sub-psychological level to a main psychological level, the distance is what, 50 pips? Okay. So, from this point, let's say you enter the trade at this point. Can you see another strategy? Price cut to this point. It came back. It broke the psychological level. You can see this psychological level. That is 1.13500. It broke. You can enter upon the initial break. But there are times you don't need to rush the market. You have to wait for a retest. Okay. Upon the retest, what happened? Okay. You place your sell. So probably you'll be entering at this point. You'll be entering at this point. They're good for you. So once you enter at this point, where would your stop be? Your stop will likely be on your recent high. Then you have to, the minimum target you should set what is 50 pips. Set 50 pips. Now let's see, with the help of our crosshair, let's see if we're able to catch 50 pips from that move. Yeah, it's 76 pips altogether. From this point, you should be out. This is 64 pips. Remember, it breaks the psychological level again. What happened? You wait for a retest. Upon the retest, you enter in for what? For a short. Remember back, was it 3 days ago or so, I sent a trade for us to sell this particular pair. But unfortunately, it didn't get to the price we are anticipating. But yes, we did got about 20 pips or 30 pips from this trade. Okay, we entered in from this point. 20 pips or 30 pips, okay, about 25 pips that we got from this trade. And we got caught, stopped out at break even. If you guys still remember, yes, I still remember this particular trade. I sent it from the 15 minutes. This was the chart right here. So this is how something. I'm so sorry. Okay, yeah. This is it. Upon the break, we entered for a sell. Somewhere around here. Upon the break, we entered for a sell. I made some money. But I entered at this point. At this point, with the help of a TDI. You can still see that on the group chat. Sorry, on the Telegram channel. At the point I entered. Boom, this is the entry right here. This is the entry. Okay, I sold at this point. Immediately, I broke even. I moved my stop loss into profit. So, I was on a risk-free trade. Then, upon the break of this trend line, counter trend line, I saw this late. Then, I had my second entry, second position. So, that's how exactly at this point. Upon the break, upon this guy, I entered here again. This was my first entry. This point was my first entry of me on the psychological level. And when it got to you, this was my second entry. Okay. I'm sure you guys are understanding this. Now let me explain one more time how I pick trade with this. Upon the break of the psychological level, wait for a retest to that point, then you trade. Upon a break, wait for a retest, trade. Let me show you examples. Okay. There's an up movement. Okay. wait for a retest. You can see the retest. Look for a candlestick formation. Upon that, what you trade. Do you understand? Do you understand, guys? It's very simple. Very simple. The logic here, very, 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 very simple. There are times that you might not get a retest. If you don't have a retest, it is fine. Let it go. If you do not have a retest, it is fine. Let that trade go. No retest, no trade. The break of a psychological level, wait for a retest. Upon the retest, placing your trade, boom. Upon the break, you see the retest to this side and immediately move to the downside. Okay? Here is another point again. Let me share the screen. I hope you guys can still hear me. Drop number one on the chat if you can hear me. If you're back, drop number one on the chat. Retest sometime. Okay, perfect. Someone is asking if retest is a must. Not, it's a must. For you to trade the strategy, it's a must. But once there's no retest, do not trade. Because sometimes you might have a fake out. There are times it just break and it goes straight to the downside. But there are times that the perfect one is when there is a retest. That's the best. That's the one best way you can trade this strategy. Another way is you use a counter trend line. That's what I do more because it's more simpler. I use the counter trend line to trade because it's more simpler. Like the one you have here. Retest on the psychological. No. The retest should be on the psychological level, not on the trend line. There are times that the trend line also have retest. Anywhere that is a breakout, anytime you see breakouts, always expect a retest. Always expect a retest. Like on the trend line, there are times that you find on the trend line. You can see this one on the trend line. Upon the break, what you trade. Upon the break of this psychological level, we wait for a retest. Upon the retest, what we trade. It will always give you something like this. Something like A, B, C to D pattern. But it's just in the form of Elliott wave, but a simplified way is break retest trade. That's a simplified way to trade this. Okay. You can see upon the break, broke to the upside. Okay. You wait for a retest. Upon the retest, form in a bullish flag pattern, boom, to the upside. And a trend line can also help you to trade this. You draw a counter trend line to this point. Upon the break, you enter long. Very simple strategy. Without the help of indicator, you can trade this strategy without the help of any indicator. Maybe next time I'll be telling you about the trade. Boom. Upon the counter trend line, can you see this one? Counter trend line. Upon the break, you enter in for your trade. Upon the break, you enter for your trade. Another one, upon the break, you entered for what? For short. Upon the break of this one, you entered long. Upon the break of this one, you entered long. Very simple, guys. Upon the break of this guy, you entered what? Long. Upon the break here, you entered what? Long. Very simple, man. It's very simple. These things happen right before our faces every day. Day in, day out. Day in, day out. Okay, let me show you one more thing. Someone's asking, how do I do my confirmation with the TDI? Okay, I said I'll talk about that next time. Okay, there's what we call TDI hook. Let me just do a quick. If you understand the TDI before, you know what we call TDI hook. I explained that on my YouTube channel. I just check that out. Okay. Okay. TDI hook. Once there is a cross between this green and red, that's a signal for you to sell to the downside. To the downside, there's a cross to this green and red, is a signal for you to sell. Couple the confirmation with on the psychological level. So I only use this one for a confirmation. Once there is a cross at this point, I sell. And that dangerous thing, another dangerous signal, you see, when I mean dangerous, is always very, 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 the move is always very drastic. When the sentimental line, I mean the sentimental line is the green line, the red one is what we call signal line, while the yellow is MBL, market baseline. Once the green crosses the yellow, it's another very, very, very sharp movement. You can just check, once there was a, when the green crossed the yellow, can you see at this point, what was the movement to the downside? Boom. We had about 214 pips. Once the green crossed the yellow, what happened? Boom, to the downside, we have about 114 pips. Whenever the green crosses the yellow, always know that there's always, there'll be a sharp movement. You can see the green crossed the yellow, what happened? Sharp movement to the upside, 101 pips. One, this thing happens in all time frames, irrespective of the time frame. You can use it to scalp, you can use it to swing, you can use it to, I'm a day trader, I use it for a day trader. I find my trend on 4 hour, I check the current trend on 1 hour, and I pick my entry on 15 minutes. As simple as that. Nothing more, nothing complicated. Okay? Yes, you must follow the trend. Since I'm a day trader, I follow 4 hour trend. I determine my trend on 4 hour. Someone is asking me, Jones is asking, how many trades do I take a week? On average, I've not been actually been able to calculate the trades. But whenever I see a valid trade setup, I pick them. Okay? But currently on this week, we have had about 3 break-evens and no stop loss this week. Yes, no stop loss. No stop loss this week. We never had our stop loss hit, but we had about 3 break-evens. Okay? What we do, basically what we do is whenever we're in profit, once I get into profit, I make sure I move my stop loss into profit. Then it becomes stop profit. So when markets reverse, when markets reverses, either hits me out in small profit or it do my thing. So that's what I do every day. That's all I do. So my intention is not to show you how to use the TDI for confirmation yet. Intention is just to show you how to trade naked with the chart. How to trade naked with the chart. So I'll still emphasize more on that because I'm still seeing some private messages. Okay, you can see this level. This is only 4 hours. Let me take it to a smaller time frame so you understand that it happened on all time frames. Let me take it to 1 hour. Let's say trade from 1 hour. You can see how price perfectly matched at this point. Price perfectly matched at this point. Any point is asking if green crossing yellow up or down. If the green crosses it down, the yellow down, sell. Then you know that there's a sharp sell movement coming. If it crosses it upward, know that there's a sharp movement upward coming. I hope that's cleared.